Hey everybody, this is Steve Heithecker from Pyramind. Welcome. These are exciting times in the world of Reason with the release of Reason 8. And I want to show you some of the awesome new features that are part of it. There's a number of new features with this, but in the first video we're going to do, we're actually going to focus on browser focus and a little bit of drag and drop. So let's look to see what we have. All right, so in the browser, new browser section, which is baked into the left part of the program, we're going to see a couple of our old friends. We're going to bring up the tool window, and we're going to see that they've redacted the device palette. And the device palette now lives in the browser. So my instruments are here, my effects, and my utilities. All right, so by default, I actually have part of what used to be the tool window permanently in the browser. Now, we can close the browser if we choose to. So we have that option as well. We don't always have to see it. For now, we're going to leave it open. So device palette now that's in the browser, I can double click to create a device. Undoing, I can drag and drop. I can single click and hit return. So all of the ways that we could think. One of the other things that they've done is they have made consistent throughout the program instrument effects utilities in different buckets or categories, if you will. So under here, instrument effects utilities, over here in the browser, and right clicking for the contextual menu gives me a thing. They also did a kind of cool thing, which is they will show you whether it's a Reason device, a rack extension, different device. You see at the bottom, it says Reason device down there. Now, apparently, and I've yet to use it possibly enough to really test this, that the more that you use Reason, the more it will intelligently put things in the top level of that folder. Kind of interesting. It's an interesting thought to be determined and got back to later after I've had some more time with it. It averages out what you use and kind of finds your personal favorites list. All right, so how does this sexy new browser work? So it is based on a device that can load and or save a patch, of course, because we have to be able to browse patches. So one of the old effects units may not come into play. The matrix may not come into play, but any of the effects devices and, of course, all of the instruments that let you load and save patches work. So let's do it. So I'm going to come over here and I'm going to right click and I'm going to create a Thor. All right. So what just happened? I create a Thor and we see that there is an orange banding or highlighting around the browse and save and select area of the device. Now, these buttons have always been here. This is not the new sexy. The new sexy is we come over here, we see browse patch for Epic Poly. So that's showing us the current patch. It is all orange, which is our Pyramind brand color and the Giants color. So we love the orange selection that they've gone through, but it also auto opens the presets folder. So the default presets for this device. So if I want to change the patch, all I got to do is double click or hit my up and down arrows. This is so easy. It's so much fun. I could go through any of the other folders that are part of this. I can simply and easily change any of these patches, and of course in a synth it's going to be pretty quick as well. So as long as this focus is here, it means it's going to show the patches that are for this device, and I can simply navigate. Now I could also click and I could hit load down here. That will force it. But then above and beyond that, I could also drag and drop. So when I drag a patch for this device over, it will highlight it with that beautiful orange once again, and I let go and it changes it. So many ways to change a patch. Drag and drop to be able to navigate through the browser with the up and down arrows, to be able to double click, to be able to hit the load button. So many ways to be able to get patches. So let's change focus. So I'm going to click echo. It now shows, well, the name of that's the Giants Win the World Series. It's an interesting name for an echo. All right. So it's showing me the current name, and it's still saying Thor patches, though. So I need to click this browse button. Now I am targeted on the echo. It is orange. It is orange. You'll always know focus is on a device when this turns orange. And now it's the same rules. I can go ahead and double click I can single click and I can hit load. I can drag onto the echo and change it. So however I want to do it, but remember to change the focus, you're going to have on an existing device anyway, you're going to have to click once, get the blue highlight on the device, and then you're going to come up here. So let's do it for the RV. We'll show this again. So now we see that this is selected here. I hit the browse, that puts focus there and we're back in. Now, let's say I actually want to just create a new reverb. I can do that as well. So drag and drop comes into play. I can click, hold, and pull. And when I get a plus, I'm going to create a different reverb. It's pretty freaking cool with that. Now, if I want to drag and drop onto an existing, then it's just going to change the patch. So really, really, really cool. And by the way, that was a combinator I chose. That's why it created that. So if I come down and let's go with an RV, I come over here, plus sign RV, just so that wasn't confusing. There's a lot of reverbs that are listed in here. So I love this. This makes it so much easier to navigate, to actually load and experiment and to try things with different patches. It also will, of course, show me all of my favorites, because that's basically what this left column is. This part of it down has always been here, right? So they've kind of consolidated a number of different functions to the browser. You can actually tell it how much width you want, depending on how much you want to see, how big of a screen. Got a 27-inch iMac with at 1920 by 1080, so I got a little bit of real estate I can actually afford to give to this. But if I want to come in here and say, look at one of my favorites, so maybe I go to Pantheon, which I love. So let's kind of see where we are. Right now, I'm still in that reverb, orange focus, right? So I'm down here. I'm looking in the browser, but I'm still not focused on this. So if I want to, I can X that. So now I'm not necessarily focused. The orange one is gone. So now I can just get a patch and I can drag and drop, and that will auto create that device. Right now, because I just created that device, the focus is there. So really, really, really cool stuff. Let's do one more. Let's create Kong and let's reset it so it's focused. I'm going to go reset. Just I'm going to go back to no samples. So let's look at some of the other ways. So we're autofocused. This is the Kong sample folder here. Now it says it's browsing patches. I'm not looking for patches. If I try to browse a patch in the sample folder, I'll get a whole lot of nothing, right? So you got to remember that. That could confuse you. I X this. Now it's no focus, which means I can see what's really in here, which are my kicks, which means I can drag and drop samples to any pad. It is so cool. I love this. I really, really do. So now I have that kick drum that's baked in there. So if you have, and I know you do, boatloads of samples, this gives you the ability to have all of your folders. All you do is drag and drop into this list of all your sample folders and then drag and drop onto any of the samplers, and it will auto map and load the samples. So NNXT, NN19, Kong, Redrum, great stuff to be able to do it. If I try to drag, let's say, a kick drum over, you'll see that it's not lighting up over the echo. It's not over the reverb. It's only when I get to a pad. So it's smart. It knows what you're trying to drag and drop and where. If I try to drag and drop this down somewhere else, you see it's not taking it. It's only when I get to that pad that it's going to do it. Now, if I'm back up into a normal device or into a patch and I drag and drop the patch, you'll see the plus sign. So it's got a lot of those nice visual indicators. Of course, the plus sign means it's going to auto create a device around that patch. So really awesome. Devil in the details. I'm going to say it again. It's subtle, but the ability to drag and drop and to have browser focus makes it an easier experience to be creative. So $129 upgrade. It is free for anybody that bought Reason 7 after July 1st, 2014. Well worth the price of admission on this one. So get it, have some fun, and I'll see you soon.
Very much like to thank Pyramind for hosting me here once again. I think this institution is really cool, and until I came here for the first time, I had never seen anything like it in my whole life.
What I think really separates us from other people who teach is that we are outrageously passionate about what we do, and especially in electronic music.
Since coming to Pyramind, I've discovered electronic music, and you know, San Francisco being a mecca for underground electronic music opened up so many doors for me, and kind of blew my mind.
We cover everything from absinthe to contact. When people get to the mind-melting level, we get into modular synthesis.
Everything about native instruments, everything about logic synths, down to the finest detail, we learned it all.
The fundamentals of understanding how things work, that's just essential. But then beyond that, there's so much more, and that's where it gets into just a lot of the artistic side of, like, the creative approach of why you do something, not just how.
There's a lot of schools that just, you know, they focus on the technicality of recording music, but I wanted something that would foster creativity and really help me develop as an artist as well.
Each of our genre-specific programs comes in four levels. There's a basic, an advanced, a professional, and then a master's level. And the master's level is, of course, everything we do. It's the largest and most powerful programs that we can create for you.